Hey guys, it's Miss Pal here, and I'm going to be going over the Temple High School Dance Department Summer School Packet. There are 6 assignments within the Summer School Packet for the Dance Department, and I'm just going to go over each one with you in this video, but also just so you know, each assignment does have instructions included with it. The first assignment that you're going to be doing is reading a dance fitness article. This article is full of a lot of great information for dancers and promoting fitness to help you become a better dancer, but also just how fitness can be incorporated into your daily routine in order to promote good health and wellness as well. At the end of this article, you will be answering 3 reflection questions. Each question must be answered with a minimum of 3 complete sentences. So again, 3 full complete sentences per reflection question, just so we're clear on how we're doing the format for those. The second assignment within the dance department packet is another article. This article features a performer, a very famous performer by the name of Misty Copeland. She's currently a principal ballerina with the American Ballet Theatre. She was also featured in the most recent movie, The Nutcracker, that came out, that recent version of that. And she's one of the spokeswomen for Under Armour, so you've probably seen her in a lot of Under Armour campaigns. She is a phenomenal performer, a phenomenal dancer. She has so much talent. She's also very active in the community. And I think that's what kind of makes her so special as well, because she kind of goes beyond dance a little bit. But you're gonna read this short article. When you finish reading it, you are gonna be writing a short answer or short essay reflection based on what you read in the article. I have given you some examples of some things you can talk about in this essay. I know essay can kind of sound scary, but this is just a 50-word minimum. Of course, you can always write more than that if you would like, but you're only required to write at minimum 50 words. That's about a half a page, depending on how big your handwriting is, and that's also probably about 5 to 6 sentences, depending on how long you're writing those sentences. So again, reading the article, taking what you learn from that article, writing a short reflection essay. The third assignment is another article, and I promise this is the last one, but it is another article, and it is centered on the famous choreographer Alvin Ailey, who also founded the Alvin Ailey Dance Company, which is based out of New York. There are several locations and a traveling company now as well, but he was a phenomenal choreographer. He's no longer with us, but he has created so many pieces that are really revolutionary within the dance world, and they show truly what his life was like during that time, and you have to go back to when he kind of grew up and became a choreographer to understand that, and the article takes you through that a lot. But this work is so still relevant in today's society. It's still works that are performed today, and people come from all over to watch them be performed. And I've actually had the chance to see Alvin Ailey, the company, perform live, and it is truly breathtaking to watch. So he was, again, just a phenomenal creator of movement. And that is a modern contemporary based company. So not ballet, but he was a modern contemporary choreographer. Same thing that you did on the previous assignment, you will be reading the article and you will be writing a short answer, a short essay reflection on what you read in the article. Again, just like last time, I gave you a couple of examples of things you can talk about, but of course you can talk about what you would like as well. You don't have to use my examples. And same thing as last time, it is 50 words minimum. Again, that's about a half a page or about 5 to 6 sentences. So just making sure that we are meeting those requirements of the 50 word minimum word count, and writing clear reflections after reading those articles. The fourth assignment is a mini choreography project. You will be writing out your choreography. I provided an example of what that looks like in the assignment, so you can see an example 8 count. You will be needing to tell me, and there are spaces for you to write this, which genre of dance you're choreographing. And by genre of dance, of course, that means like the units that we did throughout the year. So ballet, lyrical, jazz, hip hop, whatever you're wanting to choose to choreograph, make sure you note that. You will also need to note what song you did the choreography to and what artist that song is by. So song title and song artist. No, you don't need to like send me this music or anything like that, but it's just so I can get a sense of what you did choreograph, and then you will hand write out each 8-count of choreography, and that is 4 8-counts that you will be doing, okay? The fifth assignment is a combined dance costume and performance makeup assignment. Y'all know how important dance costuming is to a performance. It can really make a difference. Also, performance makeup. You won't ever go to a performance, whether it be dance, theater, anything, where they do not have some kind of stage makeup on to make their features stand out on stage. So you will be creating your own performance look, makeup, and costuming. You will need to select a performance genre as well, and then you'll be creating, again, drawing a makeup look and a costume design. There are mannequins. Well, there's a face outline for you to do your performance makeup, and then there is a mannequin outline for you to do your dance costume. Think if you were getting to pick your own performance or your own spring show routine, what would you pick? What would you want to wear? How would you want to do your makeup for that piece? And make sure that it all goes together too, because like I said, dance costuming, dance makeup really does bring a piece together, and that's going to be really important when, you know, it comes down to that performance time. If this was a real dance, you would want it to look right, okay? And then the final assignment is a dance terminology assignment. There are 8 dance terms that you will need to define with a definition. So just literally writing the definition of that word. I did not provide you with the definition. You need to do some research to find that. And then you will have a final 4, so 12 total, but the last 4 definitions are a little bit different. I've put the word that you need to define in a box. And within that box, you need to not write the definition, but you need to draw what that looks like. Just like in previous assignments, I have given you examples of both the handwritten definition and the drawing definition, and you'll see those examples and make that a little bit clearer. Again, you can research what those definitions are and pull from your research to write your own definition. You can also use your dance knowledge, and same thing with drawing it, drawing the vocabulary word, the dance term that we're using. You can use your dance knowledge, and you can also do some research on that to draw that. I know we're not all perfect artists. I mean, it can be a stick figure, as long as it's clear that that is what that dance term looks like when you perform it, okay? And those are all 6 of the assignments, so just make sure that you're getting this all done. It should not take you too long per assignment to get through this, so you can do it. Just do your best and get all of that turned in to me. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.